What's going on, guys? My name is Arjun, and welcome back to my channel. It seems like every single day, I'm seeing a new story about Bitcoin. And I'm sure many of you guys have questions about it. So in today's video, I wanted to talk about what exactly is Bitcoin, what are some of the risks associated with it, and finally, I want to give you guys what some of my questions or concerns about Bitcoin are for the future. So first, what exactly is Bitcoin? Bitcoin is a digital currency that was launched in 2009 by Satoshi Nakamoto. Now, no one knows exactly who this person is or if it's multiple people. Bitcoin is a decentralized currency that, unlike today's currencies, is not controlled by one single authority. It's built on the blockchain technology, which I'll explain a little bit more in detail later in the video. One way to think about this is similar to a virtual serial number on the dollar bill. What makes each dollar bill unique is this serial number you see. So imagine if we could turn that into a digital form of a serial number. Let's take a step back and talk about how currency has evolved over time. First, we started with a barter system, where we would trade one good or service for another good or service. Then we moved on to coins made of precious metals. And this had to do with the weight of that precious metal. The value of the coin was tied to the weight and value of the metal that they were made out of. Then we moved on to currencies backed by gold reserves, meaning the amount of currency that a country printed corresponded to the amount of gold that they had in their reserves. Currently, we have currency backed by a promise. So in this case, the US government promises that the piece of paper, the $1 bill, is worth that $1. So, what could be the future next steps? Now, we've already taken some steps in this direction. We've already moved to a form of digital currency with mobile payments, credit cards, etc. Could we see a US dollar cryptocurrency? Could we see another type of cryptocurrency take over? We don't know, but all of those are possible, and I think the next logical step is for a digital currency. So now let's take a minute to talk about the blockchain, which is the technology that Bitcoin is built around. Think about blockchain as a collection of blocks, and each block contains a list of transactions. It's a decentralized ledger system. So that means that all of the transactions that occur on the Bitcoin blockchain are recorded by the different members who maintain the blockchain. These members who maintain the blockchain are known as miners or nodes on the blockchain. All of the transactions are open and transparent. Because of this, it's difficult for somebody to cheat the system. As of January 2021, there were more than 12,000 nodes. So what's the incentive for someone to become a Bitcoin miner and help to maintain the blockchain? So mining is the process in which Bitcoins are released to the public. There's a fixed supply of 21 million Bitcoins. So miners use powerful computers to maintain the blockchain, and they are rewarded for doing this by receiving Bitcoin for creating a new block. An important point to note here is that over time, the rewards for maintaining the blockchain have come down. It's very expensive for miners to maintain the blockchain because of the computing power that's necessary and the electricity that's consumed. They're in charge of maintaining the network and enforcing the credibility of its transactions. They process the transactions, and they also receive transaction fees for processing this. So a few more important things I want you guys to know about Bitcoin. A Bitcoin transaction occurs using a public key and a private key. The public key is similar to a bank account number, and this information is what is open and transparent to everybody in the Bitcoin network. This is what gives the address for where the Bitcoin are to be sent. The private key is similar to an ATM code, and it's used to authorize transactions. So the same way that we use a debit card and then we punch in our ATM pin, you need a private key to authorize the transaction. So just so you guys can understand a little bit better, let's talk about what some of the differences are between a credit card transaction and a Bitcoin transaction. So a Bitcoin transaction is seeking to be more like cash, meaning it wants to be a one-person-to-one-person without a middleman transaction that occurs And in this case, they want it to occur anonymously on the blockchain. So a Bitcoin transaction also will have lower fees relative to a credit card transaction. An important point here is that a Bitcoin transaction is irreversible, and there's just an overall lower level of acceptance right now around Bitcoin. Whereas a credit card transaction involves four major parties: the cardholder and merchant, and then the cardholder's bank, and the merchant's bank. All of the people involved in this process have access to this information of the transaction, as including the buyer's name and address, and all of this information is recorded and stored in centralized ledgers, as opposed to the decentralized ledgers for the blockchain. Some of the advantages that credit cards have over Bitcoin, however, are fraud protection, the ability to borrow cash, and an overall wide acceptance. One other term you'll hear thrown around a lot is a Bitcoin wallet. And if you guys want more information on that, I can make a separate video about it. But basically, think about a Bitcoin wallet as a way to facilitate trading of Bitcoin and track ownership. One of the major questions that people have around Bitcoin is, will there be wide acceptance of it? Right now, we don't know the answer to that. There have been some developments this year which point towards it being more widely accepted. First, Tesla invested $1.5 billion in Bitcoin and announced that they would be accepting Bitcoin as a payment method for their cars. There have also been other major companies to invest in Bitcoin. Square invested $170 million into Bitcoin this past quarter. Now, one thing I want you guys to know also is that many investors in Bitcoin may see this less of a currency and more of a possible hedge against inflation, similar to the way that gold is traded. So now I want to touch on some of the risks involved in Bitcoin. The first is that it doesn't have the stability of a currency. Between January and February of 2018, Bitcoin lost 65% of its value. Now, this is too big of a swing for any country to use Bitcoin as its currency. The second risk is around regulatory risks. Bitcoin are the rival of government money because the government can't track this money. So in the same way that they're trying to get rid of black money, it's possible that Bitcoin could be used for the black market and money laundering, and governments may seek to regulate or even ban Bitcoin completely. The next risk is around security risks. So most people buy and sell Bitcoin using exchanges, but it's possible that the exchange itself could be hacked. For example, back in 2014, there was a very popular Bitcoin exchange called Mt. Gox. This was a Bitcoin exchange based out of Japan. They were hacked and had nearly $400 million worth of Bitcoin stolen from them. And because a Bitcoin transaction is irreversible, there was nothing they could do to get people their money back. That money was lost. The final risk I want to note is the tremendous environmental impact that maintaining the blockchain has. Bitcoin uses more energy than the country of Argentina, and if Bitcoin were a country, it would rank in the top 30 in the world as far as energy consumption goes. So there is a significant environmental impact that comes from maintaining Bitcoin. So now that you guys understand more about Bitcoin, here are some questions that I have about it and its future. The first is that what will happen when the entire supply of Bitcoin is mined? Meaning, what happens when miners no longer get Bitcoin for maintaining the blockchain? Will they be able to sustain themselves simply with the transaction fees that they get? Could countries ban the use of Bitcoin or create their own cryptocurrency? So could there be a US dollar cryptocurrency? And what happens to Bitcoin in this case? If Bitcoin really became more stable like a currency, will the appeal exist to invest in Bitcoin? Right now, I think there's a large number of people who are investing in Bitcoin because there is the potential to gain quite a bit, meaning that Bitcoin can move up very quickly. If Bitcoin were more stable like other currencies, does that same appeal still exist? These are just some of the questions that came to me in my research, and hopefully you guys were able to learn a little bit more about Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies in this video. I hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you want to learn more about business and investing, comment, like, subscribe to my channel, and let's head on over to the next video.